name's Judy, and I love my socks, right? I even knitted a lot of them, and I keep them in a drawer. But for the past 3 mornings in a row, I found this pair somewhere else, not in the sock drawer. So I'm making this video diary because something seriously weird is going on. It's 2:52 a.m. and can you hear that? My socks are crying. I'm serious, they're fucking well weeping. I've called the police. They should be here any minute. Did you see that? I called the land agent today to talk about breaking the lease. And she was so mean to me. You know, she was all la-di-da, the law this, the law that. Bitch! Anyway, when I got done telling her all about the ghost living in my sock drawer, she changed her tune, oh. She sure changed her tune then, didn't she? Actually, I think I frightened her, but she did make one very good suggestion. She told me I should call in a priest to perform an exorcism. I think I better, because my socks, every night, they're just crying and crying. And, you know, it's like they're saying, you should never have needed us. But I just wanted warm feet. I just wanted warm feet. I wanted warm feet. Oh, God. Warm feet. These were my favourite pair of socks. But things didn't go so well with the priest. He had an accident on my kitchen floor. You know, I thought I would tell him all about my troubled socks and he'd bless them with some holy water and it would be over. That's how it was supposed to be, but God, I should have had the camera rolling. No one's ever going to believe what happened. It's like I handed him my socks and at first he just held them. And he said all these sort of God things at them and things were fine. But the next thing you know, he screamed in pain. And then he broke out in this hideous smelly sweat and his face got all red and contorted. And it was like the devil at my kitchen table. And then my socks exploded. And there was wool flying everywhere. And that's when he had his accident on my kitchen floor and ran out. God. I should have had the camera rolling, because it was just... Oh, God.
Hello. I'm Justina, and I like to go to bed with my dressing gown and slippers on. And turn off all the lights and put some nice, easy listening music on. And open a packet of my favorite baby bears. And that's when I feel truly safe. It's a funny thing being one of the survivors of a bungled armed robbery. You're one of the lucky ones because it wasn't you shot in the bloody head by it. And that thing they did to that poor old lady, that was just sickening. I suppose I'd feel better if they were all dead. The robbers. I know this lady had a man break into her home and do awful things to her, and he told her he'd come back, and so she'd better not tell the police. She's the one that told me to go to bed with my slippers on. So if they come for you, you've got something on your feet, ready to run. I hired a private detective to track down her attacker for her birthday. She'd like to kill him, see? It's the only way, isn't it? For a woman to feel safe again, knowing the bugger is 6 feet under. We're going to dump his body in the river out yonder. No one will miss that one. At least my own robbers are behind bars, but they'll be out again. Mark my words. Arsenic in the porridge. That's what they should be doing in prisons, I think. Save taxpayers' money. Some people don't deserve to live. I don't care what you say.
Hello, I'm Betty. And I do not sleep naked. I feel too vulnerable when I'm lying in bed without any clothes on. Like I should hang a neon sign above the bed saying, "Pick this one, she's already plucked." Hot chicken on a rotisserie. So exposed, vulnerable. Like all my entry points are on display. Easy picking for the right and the wrong guy, easy prey. You see, this is what it feels like. I'm being fucked by a stranger hiding in the bushes at the edge of the driveway. Hello. I wonder if he's touching himself. Whose name will he call out when he comes? It's so eerie, the way he's feeling me up with his eyes like that. I'm sure you know what I mean. We've all had that feeling of being watched, haven't we? Public space. It can swallow you whole if you don't take care. So yes, I wear flannel pyjamas, and let's not speak any more about it.
My name is Anna, and this is my bed. Ah, yes. Anyone who had a heart, you know. They would love me. But not my Tom. Oh, no. He's a bit off in the head, my Tom. Yeah, his mum told me about this incident when he was just a lad. Down at the local swimming pool, some of the popular boys tried to drown him. And he was dead for a few minutes before they could resuscitate him. And that's where I think the evil got into him. I reckon that's what evil is, this sort of vaporous cloud of nastiness that hangs about at road accidents and whatnot, trying to slip into someone's body when they're not there for a few minutes. Like with Tom. Mean he is. He's got a really mean streak. But I was overweight. You see, hair was a little bit stringy, problem with body odour. I mean, all that's sorted now. But at the time when I met Tom down the local pub, I wasn't the prettiest pea in the pod, eh? Girls like me learn to take what we can get, throw the dog a bone and all that. Used to hear that quite often down the local pub. Go on, Bob, throw the dog a boner to suck on. And I would. Suck on the men in the toilet cubicles. Felt like it was the best I could do. Tom, he forced himself on me in the car park one night after closing. It was all right, I suppose. In hindsight. But he got me pregnant. And the local coppers put it to him that either he goes to jail or marries me. And I don't know, I guess we had a few good years there in the beginning for what it was. A loveless marriage isn't going to send you over the moon now, is it? Anyway, I guess these things build over time, don't they? Resentment, anger. I don't know, it was just, he was just sleeping like a log, snoring like he always does. And it was so easy to just pour the petrol over him. And they weren't fire retardant, his pajamas, so the fabric went up in flames and sort of fused to his skin. What was left of it? You know, and I'd be lying if I didn't admit that I took some pleasure in flushing that man's ashes down the toilet. And the police still think it was a suicide. But you mark my word. God is on my side on this. Because God understands evil.
My name's Helen, and well, I don't know, they're just so damn comfortable, aren't they? Now, when I had the clinical depression and panic disorder diagnosed, it seemed like it's the most natural thing in the world to just pop on my little Miss Naughty pajamas. Yeah. Oh, and my slippers. And sometimes a dressing gown if winter's set in. It's the safest and happiest place in the world to be, I think. Tucked up in my little flat. All day, all night in my pajamas. Nobody bothers me anymore. It's been 4 years now. I just get my groceries delivered and log onto the internet if I need a bit of company, so. And at first I felt a bit suicidal, the way that everybody just gave up on me as though, you know, depression's contagious or something. But about a year in, I suddenly realised how free I was. I mean, because most people hide their mental illness, so I just embraced mine. So nobody trusts a woman in her 40s who wears Little Miss Naughty pyjamas for 4 years in a row, and so nobody expected anything from me anymore. They stopped nagging me to do things, and my family just sort of faded away like a distant memory. Bad mistake I made in my 20s. And so now I've got this wonderful freedom to just bloody well do what I want. Finally. Time to just be myself, time to relax. Oh, and they pop you on the pension when you've lived in your pyjamas for 4 years.